training areas. Here, you will learn begin moving forward. Follow the waypoints to the firing area. Icons are blue. You can see several markers on the screen. The cursor, which the turret of your tank follows, the marker indicating the direction of the tank. Take into consideration that the mouse aiming cursor is not a gun sight and only serves to help you turn the tank turret in the right direction. You should not shoot without waiting for the tank turret to align itself with the opponent. If you want to hit the enemy tank, wait for the turret to turn towards the opponent. Align the crosshair with the target. It will change color when it is over the opponent. And fire. Move the cursor over the indicated tank. To be aligned with the cursor. Switch to gunner view. You can use zoom to get a better view. The aim assist indicator in the center of the screen shows where the shell will strike when you fire a shot. It turns red if the current shell cannot pierce the armor, yellow if it is possible to pierce, and green if your shell can easily pierce the armor. Depending on your target's armor thickness, the aim assist indicator changes to various colors. One of the best ways to destroy a tank is to put its crew out of action. Move the reticule over the central area of the tank. Now, fire at the fighting compartment on the tank.
Next target!
When a shell penetrates armor, the X-ray window of the enemy tank is considered destroyed if it has no crew members remaining inside. Great! If there was any crew in this vehicle, they would be in big trouble. Now, switch to third-person view. Most armored vehicles have their engines at the rear. Continue by moving the reticule onto the rear of the indicated tank. Now, switch to gunner view and fire at the tank engine. If the engine, ammo rack, or fuel tanks inside the tank are damaged, this may cause an explosion or start a fire. Good job! Move on to another cavalier.
The enemy tank has been destroyed!
Now, you have to complete a real combat assignment. Capture an... You can see a marker above the capture point. If the marker is white, this means that the point is currently neutral. Move to the capture zone.
Capture the zone while it still has enemy vehicles in it. Destroy the enemy tank.
capture zone and wait for the marker to turn blue and for a message to appear notifying you that you have captured the zone. The capture zone's marker has turned blue. That means the zone now belongs to your team. If the enemy team had captured the zone, the marker would have turned red. Capturing strategic points is one of the main methods of winning a battle. When one team captures more strategic points than the other team, the enemy team begins to lose point. Victory is achieved when the enemy team loses all its points. So, always try to keep control of the strategic zones. Great job! You won! Now you're a true tanker! to part one of the basic tutorial. In mouse aim mode, you can control your plane simply by pointing the cursor at the place where you want to fly to. Point your cursor at the waypoint, and you'll see how easy it is to fly. That's it! Proceed to the waypoint. Increase the throttle to fly slowly. Increase the throttle to 30%. You can see the aircraft's current speed in the upper left corner of the screen. The current engine power percentage is shown. As you can see, the aircraft's speed depends on its engine power. Decrease the power if you want to fly slower. Increase it if you need to fly faster. Increase the throttle until war emergency power is enabled. Its own goals and objectives, which must be. Your first enemy is before you, a balloon. You can see several markers on the screen. You will be unable to hit your opponent if you move the targeting cursor onto them with your mouse. The rounds will fly in the direction that the crosshair is aimed. You will also be unable to hit a moving object if you move the targeting crosshair directly onto it, as the target will move while the rounds fly forward and the burst will miss. To hit the opponent, put the targeting crosshair over the lead angle indicator of the enemy plane and fire. You need to fire. Now your aircraft has started to turn towards the target. You need to aim the crosshairs at the lead angle indicator. Your sight. While fighting, you will zoom in to see your target better. Return to the original view. Your machine gun. Now, you need to steer away from the ground. To quickly change the direction your aircraft is heading, move the cursor to the edge of the screen and hold it there until the aircraft completes the turning maneuver.